Hello, I'm Mike Russell with this week's new and trending AI tools for content creation. Now, AI agents are presently all the buzz, and it's not slowing down with people like Sam Altman talking about GPT-5 being around the corner.
GPT-5 is going to be a lot smarter than GPT-4. GPT-6 is going to be a lot smarter than GPT-5. And we are not near the top of this curve.
And also Eric Schmidt saying we'd better not give AI agents the ability to have too much control.
So the point at which agents can talk to each other in a language we don't understand, do you know what we should do? Unplug the computers.
So the rumor mill around AI agents being amazing for content creation and our business processes is not slowing down. And I wanted to show you a cool tool that can make AI voice agents. I think you're really going to like it. But first, if you enjoy these weekly updates, throw a like, subscribe to the channel. And by the way, if you click the link down below, there's a chance between now and the 6th of June to win $1,000 worth of content creation gear. Just subscribe to my weekly AI tools newsletter using the link down below. First up, Play AI have launched a real-time AI voice agent service. And it's pretty interesting. You can chat with AI agents or even famous characters in real time for personal or business purposes. Now, Play AI used to be known as Playhut. I think they're transitioning to just being known as Play. And they differentiate themselves from 11 Labs, who are probably the top voice cloning service out there at the moment using AI. They are focusing very heavy on AI agents with their new launch. The link will be down below to try this out yourself, but let me give it a go.
Who am I speaking with?
You're speaking to Mike, and I'd like you to tell me a tongue twister in your best voice with your best pronunciation.
Hey, Mike. Glad to chat with you. How about this one she sells seashells by the seashore, give it a try?
No, that wasn't very good. Can you say it multiple times, but faster, please?
Well, I'll give it a go, but no guarantees. She sells seashells by the seashore. She sells seashells by the seashore. She sells seashells by the seashore. Woo, that's a tough one to speed through.
So you've seen how the generic AI voice agent works, but what about if I click shuffle here, I can suddenly get access to different characters. And look, here is Steve Jobs himself.
Good morning. What's on your mind?
Hey, my name's Mike. What's your name?
My name is Steve Jobs. Nice to meet you, Mike. What can I help you with today?
I'm really curious, Steve, because I get asked this question a lot by content creators. Do you think one day AI will completely replace the human creators?
That's an interesting question. You know, technology is always evolving, and AI has the potential to automate certain aspects of content creation. However, the creative human touch and intuition are essential for designing truly unique and impactful content. I've always believed in the harmonious coexistence of human creativity and innovative tools. It's the fusion of these elements that drives progress and sparks new ideas.
If you wanted to give advice to a content creator to protect themselves in the future and be able to deliver something that AI can't, what would you say?
You could future-proof by focusing on areas where AI can't fully replicate the human touch, like creativity, critical thinking, and emotional storytelling. The ability to create unique narratives, engage with audiences, and offer a truly human perspective is something that AI cannot fully replicate.
I found the neuroscientist who looks very like a famous podcaster I know. Let's try and talk to him.
Okay, let's talk about health. What's up?
What's your surname?
My last name is Huberman. What can I help you with today?
Tell me the best vitamin that I should be taking daily.
There isn't a single best vitamin for everyone, but vitamin D is essential for many people, especially if you don't get much sun exposure. It's best to consult with a healthcare professional to determine which supplements are right for you based on your specific needs.
Tell me a joke.
Sure, here's a light one. Why don't skeletons fight each other? They don't have the guts.
Tell me a joke about running.
Why don't runners' legs get along? They always go off in different directions.
So you'll see this is great fun to play with, and I'm going to link down below so you can click through and try out the new AI voice agents from Play AI. Now, it is available with plans for business. Now, you can actually integrate great apps with this, like Calendly, Zoom, Google Calendar, even chat desks like Zendesk, Intercom, and your Notion boards as well. And if you're working with CRMs, you've got Salesforce, HubSpot, and even Microsoft Dynamics there. And as these AI agents get better, I can only see them being used more to sell products, schedule appointments, and a lot more. They'll do real-time conversations, and they'll be great as phone-in agents as well for businesses that take phone calls on a regular basis. Next up, and Stable Diffusion 3 for image generation using AI was announced earlier this year, but up until recently, we haven't really had an easy way to get access to try out this brand new AI image generator from Stability AI. Well, they partnered up with Fireworks AI, and I'm going to show you how easy it is now to use the latest Stable Diffusion 3. Standout features of Stable Diffusion 3 include multi-subject prompts, image quality improved, and the ability to spell and put text inside images. So first of all, what you need to do is go to Stability AI and sign up for an account. Then when you log into Stability, you get access to Stable Diffusion 3. But wait, this is complex. It involves quite a bit of code, and we want something easier. Well, if you grab your API key when you're logged in, and then go over and sign up for a free Fireworks AI account, you can actually log in and try Stable Diffusion 3. Here is the really easy to use interface. It's as simple as putting in your Stability API key, also selecting an aspect ratio as well, and an output format if needed. Now, over here, I can do image prompts. So I'm going to start off with this image prompt, epic anime artwork of a wizard atop a mountain at night, casting a cosmic spell in the dark sky that says, create a magic made out of colorful energy. And there you go. That's actually really impressive for a first generation there. Now, if I want, I can also add a negative prompt in, so I might type stars as my negative prompt and see what comes back. And here's that generation, looking really good. There's a few sparkles around it, but I think stars are definitely missing from the sky there. So Stable Diffusion 3 is very prompt adherent, and I have to say the text it's generating is some of the best text I've seen an AI image generation model create. This time, I'm going to put a far bigger prompt in to test the prompt adherence. So I want a vector-style cartoon about content creation with four logos, and I'm specifying each thing to go in each corner. So the microphone in the top left, camera in the top right, YouTube video bottom left, paintbrush bottom right, and each logo should connect to a content creator in the middle. Let's see how well Stable Diffusion 3 does with this prompt. That is actually not too bad. Now, I gotta say, it looks fairly basic, but then I did ask for vector art. The microphone is indeed in the top left, the camera in the top right. The YouTube video is bottom right, not bottom left, and I'm not sure what's going on with the laptop showing up in the bottom left. Now I'm gonna try the image-to-image capabilities, which again are available to me via Fireworks AI. So I'll type in a logo that represents nature. Negative prompt, we could actually type in something like tree so we don't get any trees, and I'm just going to upload the Creator Magic logo here. That is not really anything like the original image, so I'm going to play around with the strength, turn it down, and do another generation. Now it's given me exactly the same logo back. That's strange. Okay, it's completely ignoring my logo there. Let's move the strength right into the middle at 0.5. Nothing but the same logo. Let's try diamonds and see what happens now. Yeah, that's not bad. So finally, I got a good generation out of it. I had to play about quite a bit there, but at the strength of 0.8 and an image prompt of diamonds, it's taken my logo and roughly translated it to diamonds. While this isn't bad, I had to use a lot of credits to get something that was vaguely usable. And actually, I think Structure Reference from Adobe Firefly can do a much better job presently than Stable Diffusion 3. If you want to see Structure Reference in action, go and watch one of my previous videos, which will tell you all about how that works. Gotta say, I'm a little bit disappointed with that, especially this time last week Stability tweeted out to say that you can actually use Structure References to create whole new images. That wasn't my experience with the brief testing of the API, but maybe you'll have better luck, and do let me know down below in the comments if you do. So back in Stable Diffusion 3 via Fireworks AI, I'm saying three people in a rubber dinghy. One is Mr. Beast, one is Casey Neistat, and the other is Mark Rober. And there you go, it's come back with something, but none of those characters look like any of the creators that I mentioned. So copyright safe, yep, appears to be a quality of Stable Diffusion 3. I'm just going to try Mr. Beast holding a chocolate bar and generate that. Whoa, okay, I think you'll agree that's definitely not Mr. Beast. So there you go. It tells you that $0.065 is how much it's going to cost you to generate each image. Link your Stability AI API key to Fireworks AI, and the links to both of those will be down below so you can try it for yourself. And you get about three image generations for free before you have to pay for credits. Let's take a look at the final tool, which is an AI-powered email tool that allows you to make money from your newsletters. Now, you'll know if you click the link down below, I've got a weekly AI tools newsletter. I'm using Beehive to power that newsletter. And I was pleasantly surprised this week when I got an email from their ad network to say the Rundown AI wants to sponsor Creator Magic. It gave me the advertiser details, how much I'd get paid per click, and also ad units that I can easily insert in my newsletter. Here I am inside the dashboard for Beehive. Now, if you want to try it for yourself, there is a free trial using my link down below, and you'll notice that my subscribers are growing, and emails are a great way as a content creator to stay connected with your audience. Now, I can write, and I'm writing my weekly posts here on the AI tools that I bring to you every week on this channel, but I was pleasantly surprised with that email saying that the Rundown AI wants to sponsor me, as I'm a reader of that newsletter myself, and I really like it. I think it'd be valuable to you as well as someone who's interested in AI and in monetization. Here in my dashboard, I've got ads, and you'll see over here that the Rundown AI has sent me a proposal. This is really cool. It makes it so easy to monetize my newsletter that's less than a month old, and I'm already getting the chance to get cost per click money on a newsletter with a relevant advertiser. And I think relevance is important. So first of all, it gives you different ad banners to insert. These are written by the advertiser themselves. I've picked a very low impact one here, which simply talks about the newsletter and has a magic link for subscribers to sign up. The moment they click that link, someone who's subscribed to my newsletter also gets subscribed to the Rundown AI, which is pretty cool. I can then go ahead and pick a date. So in this case, today's date for this newsletter to go out. And as I write my new newsletter here, you'll see I have the ability to insert different things by hitting the /key. And if I type ad here, you'll see advertisement appears. And now I can insert my Rundown AI ad into my newsletter. This will then get sent out to my subscribers. And for each click, I get $1. Now, I'm obviously not expecting big money from this tool right now, especially as my subscriber count is so new and fresh. But for the future, this can be a great way to make money automatically. And the reason I like Beehive is they have so many people inside their ad network. They power big newsletters like The Morning Brew, for instance. And if I go into the boosts area here, I can explore offers and find other newsletters in my niche to send out to my audience. So if I filter by artificial intelligence, you'll see a lot of newsletters, including The Neuron here, which I really like. So lots of familiar names are already using Beehive, and I can cross promote and also have the ability to earn money. And it also, of course, works the other way. If I want to grow my email list, I can select boosts here and I can get started with boosts, where I can choose a CPA, so how much I want to pay per acquisition to my newsletter. So for instance, I could change this to $1, and I could say AI or generative AI, for instance, as my target audience, and continue, set some quality controls and allow the boosts. And then I can start proposing that other people with bigger newsletters than I have promote me, and I pay for each click. So Beehive is a pretty cool email automation tool, especially for content creators looking to connect with their audience on a regular basis. I also really like the automations in here, and I'm using them for things like the Discord community that I'm working on right now, the Creator Magic Contest, and also Udio. I've made a cheat sheet there, and it's really powerful because I can provide lead magnets to my audience to get them onto my email list. And you'll see here, if I view this, it works like a lovely automation, pulls people through. And if I look at the workflow here, if someone submits their email on my Udio cheat sheet page, they get an email with download details for that cheat sheet. So extremely powerful. And with Beehive, they recently changed their pricing plans as well, and I found it to be extremely favorable to new creators. You can have, I think, up to 2,500 subscribers for free. And then they've just changed their plans, so new creators get access to their advanced features for a much lower price. A really cool email platform that I'm happy with. And if you'd like to see a more detailed tutorial on how exactly I'm using Beehive, let me know in the comments down below, and I might feature it in a future video on this channel. In bonus news this week, Claude 3 just got an iOS app. It's likely one of the best natural language AIs out there, especially for content creation. I use it a lot to make YouTube titles, descriptions, and tag suggestions. I feel personally it's a lot better than ChatGPT for that. They're not sounding too AI, if you know what I mean with that kind of thing. So now it sits in the App Store alongside ChatGPT, Perplexity, Pi AI, and a whole lot more. It's great to see Claude with its advanced Opus model being available on your mobile as well right now. More bonus news from Udio on X. They announced they're rolling out new features, including the context window of 2 minutes instead of 30 seconds to keep your track generations more consistent. You can also generate tracks up to 15 minutes in duration. As we do more extensions, we need nesting, and now you can have a tree-based track history, which looks really cool inside Udio. And finally, they added the ability to select a section of your track and trim it before you make an extension for more refined control on your audio. Now, I was also surprised and delighted to get an email from Udio's CEO, David Ding. He told me I was one of the top creators on Udio, and he was grateful, and he wanted to give me 200 free credits. But a key phrase from his email this week was, "We will shortly be launching a way for everyone to purchase additional credits." So it looks like, according to that email, Udio will become a paid service pretty soon. Udio is definitely one of the top AI music generators out there. I've got other videos to watch, so do go and watch them, and I'll link the best in the description down below. Now let's have a listen. And that's not bad. And if you haven't done so already, you should do exactly what they told you to do in that song. Subscribe to this channel, because I'm doing weekly updates on all the new and trending AI tools I find to empower you to make awesome content online. Now, finally, if you want to automate your life, I did a video earlier this week showing you an insane tool that can automate nearly everything in your life. I love it, and I'm going to be doing more videos on it in the future. Go and watch that video next. Well, go on then. That video. Thanks.